Okay, today we'll talk about interactive navigation and visualization of digitized archaeological excavations. Okay, this is a short overview of the presentation. Firstly, we'll talk about different methods that we can use to obtain 3D models. 3D models that represent the geometry and the texture of real artifacts. And then we'll talk about interactivity. This is the excavation site. It's the same that my colleague talked about, the matrix location where it was discovered. Okay, so back when we started to digitize 3D excavations, we used this type of drawings. So 2D drawings drawn by the archaeologist. We use them and insert them in computer-aided software to generate 3D models. So this is a resultant model. Here we have all the planes aligned with the excavation, and we can hide and unhide different components and different layers. The application used to develop this 3D excavation is CATIA V5, an engineering software used mostly for mechanical engineering. But it can also be used with great success in this kind of application. Later, we managed to acquire a 3D laser scanner. This is the first scanner that we acquired that can capture geometry and texture. And we use this scanner to digitize a water pipe that has been found in the 2012 excavation campaign. Because the 3D scanner is older, it requires for us to preset a specific volume, and the 3D scan had to be divided in multiple sessions. So these are all the sessions. It's roughly around 3 meters. Okay, and this is a short animation within the 3D scanning application, and we have the first object loaded. Okay. After that, in 2014, our team applied for a project involving conservation and revitalization of cultural and heritage and natural heritage. Here is the project title and a plant and partners. Okay, the project is supported by the EEA financial mechanism. During this project, we managed to acquire a terrestrial laser scanner that we used to digitize the entire sacred area from the fortress of Sarmisegetusa region. This is an image of the paved Dacian road. Okay, and this is a terrestrial scanning of a digging excavation. Okay, this is a cutout because the scanner requires the whole 360, and we were only interested in the geometry for the excavation area. This is the resulted model. Okay, and using that model, we also wanted to generate 3D models using more cost-efficient solutions. For that, we used two different cameras, and we use a photogrammetry software called Autodesk Memento. So, the photos has been taken 360 horizontally around the digging site and also at different levels on the vertical. Okay, this is the workflow that we used to frame the digging site precisely so that the 3D model can be generated with no gaps. This is the resulted 3D model within the Memento application. Okay. As you can see, the texture and the geometry has a pretty good resolution. Okay. And after that, because we had the 3D terrestrial laser scan and the two models generated by two different cameras, so the first, the 70D, is a 20 megapixel camera, and the second is a 50 megapixel. For both sections, again, we section only the area that it was interesting for our research, and we analyze the deviation analysis between the terrestrial scanner and each model generated using photogrammetry. For that, we use again CATIA V5 engineering solution. Here is the terrestrial scan point cloud important within the application. And on the second layer, it is the model generated using the 70D Canon camera. Okay. Here are the results in a color map, and we can see different deviations. As we can see, mostly of the excavation is in green. That means quite small deviations, roughly about 4 centimeters. That was for the lower end camera for 70D, and for the 5DSR, they are even lower. Okay. So let's see. After we have the 3D models, what do we do with them? We use 3DF PDFs that we store in our database, but we also use the Sketchfab platform to share these models on different applications. The platform is very well suited for mobile devices like smartphones and tablets. Okay, so here is our database. As my colleague said, we have the whole project. We need to digitize 500 artifacts. Here are around 250. Okay. Some are iron, some are pottery, some are stone. Okay. And now let's talk about how we interact with these models. So the first sensor that we use is called LeapMotion. It's a small sensor that has two IR infrared cameras. Okay, so this is an application created inside Unity that allows us to interact with the model. Okay, so that is the digitized digging, the excavation. Okay, we still need to work a bit on the mesh collision. Okay. So inside the application, we have the possibility to reposition the camera or add different artifacts and create a complex application. Okay. Or we can use that same sensor to interact with the 3D models. It's an application that we can use to present a pot, a Dacian vessel. Okay, so this sensor is able to acquire the position of two hands, one left and one right, within a pretty big area. Okay, the second sensor that we use, it's called Kinect, the first Kinect 360 one. And we use this to create interaction inside virtual environment. This is an application created in a standalone virtual environment. It's made in a CryEngine, okay, and we have the possibility to move around the virtual environment. Okay, the second one is inside an online browser. The graphics aren't as good as in the standalone, but this is much easier to disseminate and to send to other potential viewers. We want to add all these devices within an interactive museum where we will have the real artifacts presented, but as well have the clones digitally so that the user can interact. For example, there is a huge anvil. In real life, it's like 50 kilos. It's really hard to pick up, but in virtual environment, you could easily pick it up and see the bottom of the anvil and so on. Okay, so my conclusions. Firstly, the archaeological site where we do most of our research is in a remote place. There is no electricity or no cell phone coverage. So using the terrestrial scanner that we acquired, we can use it there because we can power it either from a car or using a diesel generator. But in comparison, if you just go with a small camera, we can easily digitize an excavation. What we want to do next, we want to create multiple layers. So When the archaeologist will dig a bit, we will come and digitize the first layer, then the second, and at the end we will stack them all on top of each other and position the 3D model right exactly where they were found. Okay. Also, for interactive navigation and visualization, it's really hard to import 3D models that were generated using laser terrestrial scanning. Even in my first presentation, you could easily see that the application, the CATIA V5, was a bit lagging because of the high volume of points there. We can filter them, but if we filter them, we lose part of the precision. Okay. So plans for the future. We want to improve the applications, the LeapMotions one and the Kinect, and maybe even integrate both sensors into the same application. We have an open day event there in the field. We present these applications to different tourists. And from our experience, we saw that kids and teenagers are native attracted to tablets and stuff like this that they use at home. So we want to create them good applications that we can use them to promote cultural heritage assets. Okay, again, the acknowledgement from the project that founded us, and we managed to do all this. And a little bit about me. I've just finished my PhD last year, November. My research has been focused on 3D laser scanning. I work in digital reconstruction. My thesis was focused on an ancient Dacian shield that was fragmented, and I have scanned it and then reconstructed all the patterns on it, and then integrated the model in different virtual reality and augmented reality applications. Okay, thank you for your attention. Do you have any questions?